Salah Ali's family has owned this neighborhood store for 33 years, selling groceries and newspapers to New Yorkers of all walks of life. But now the Yemeni-American is refusing to sell the New York Post, after it printed this cover featuring the burning Twin Towers and a quote from a Muslim congresswoman. He says Representative Ilhan Omar's quote about someone doing something, seemingly downplaying the attacks of September 11th, was taken out of context. Ali says it's not the first time the conservative-leaning publication has tried to equate his religion with terrorism.
They're always trying to make us look like monsters, but if you who sells their paper? It's us, Muslims. We are really the key into their money-making.
Omar says since President Trump tweeted her image interspersed with shots of the attacks, she's seen an increase in death threats against her.
Ali is not alone in his outrage. He's a member of the Yemeni-American Merchants Association, which represents thousands of independent store owners in New York City. The association is calling on its members to boycott the Post for 30 days unless they get an apology.
The association first flexed its political muscle 2 years ago, closing stores in protest of the president's travel ban, which affected several Muslim-majority countries. The Post has defended its work in an editorial, accusing Omar and her allies of playing the victim. What's out of context, the editorial says. She claimed that Muslim civil liberties suffered as a result of the nation's reaction to 9/11, even as she completely, intentionally disregarded the grim facts of that day. The Yemeni American Merchants Association says the Post editor should resign.
So we've been here for a long time. We've been citizens for a long time. We've been contributing to American society every day, New York society every day. And for the Post, most of their newspapers would be sold through our businesses.
Right now, a couple hundred stores have committed to the boycott, but they are looking to partner with other groups and keep the pressure on. Kristen Saloomey, Aljazeera, New York.